An interface is software that allows communication between Pi server and a data source. So typically what that means is the data source is the origin of the data, and traveling in this direction, we bring that data from the data source into the Pi server. Now these data sources, we tend to talk a lot about control systems like Siemens or Yokogawa or Honeywell, but of course there's a whole variety of data sources, from IT resources to phone systems to, well, heck, we've looked at telemetry from NASCAR. I mean, there's all different types of data sources out there, and Pi system is a general tool that can be used with all of them, although historically we've started in the manufacturing world. So these data sources are, you know, the origin of all of the things that we're interested in, typically from the interface. The data source is going to be read from by the interface application itself. Okay. Now that interface establishes a connection with the data source. We have interface specialists who have, you know, have written interfaces to hundreds of different data sources in the field. Okay. So it's that interface that establishes the connection and starts retrieving data. Now that interface generally is going to send the data directly to the Pi server, except we do have another layer called buffering that is an option, and a very highly recommended option. Buffering is something that will more or less get itself in between the interface and the Pi server. And so when the interface tries to send data to the Pi server, the buffering, which typically starts before the interface, is going to intercept it and then forward that along to the Pi server. Now the beauty of that is if for any reason the Pi server is not available, then this interface will automatically do buffering using that buffering subsystem. So we'll take that data and store it locally. Now as we see here in this drawing, the interface does not have to run on this data acquisition node, which is labeled optional. You can run an interface on the Pi server itself. Typically we don't recommend that because, well, this is a Pi server that may have hundreds of users, and that's not the best platform to use for high-speed data collection. You know, when people log out at the end of a long day, you know, it's 4:30, everybody's logging out of the system, that's probably not the best time to try to be retrieving data at high speed. Or let's say somebody sends an email out that points out some anomaly in your history, and everybody, you know, swarms over to the process book and data link and starts looking at that data. When you've got a lot of user interactions as you do on the server, see, that's not the time to be trying to retrieve data at high speed. So there's some good reasons that we suggest using these data acquisition nodes. Now ultimately the decision as to whether you have one of these data acquisition nodes or not, that really depends on several things: your network architecture, you know, the bandwidth available to you, which interfaces are being used, and the types of data sources that are monitored. So, you know, it's not always the right thing to have a data acquisition node, but that's typically where we suggest people start. In fact, sometimes when people are interested in doing redundant servers, if they don't have a data acquisition node first, we'll tell them, we'll just save your money on the redundant hardware first. Let's get a data acquisition node, because those have been so successful over the years. We really suggest that as a good starting point. So again, to summarize, the interface is collecting data from the data source. It's typically located on a different computer, a data acquisition node, but it can in fact run on the Pi server, although we typically don't recommend that.